Hi everyone and welcome back! Today I'm going to create a lovely card using a couple of stencils that have been released by Altenew. These are really unique because you can combine them to create a completely different look than what you see. So you can see at the back how you can put one on top of the other. I'm going to put them in action today so you can see what a lovely result they give, and I absolutely love that they are completely neutral gender, so you can use the result for both men and women and pretty much for any occasion. By the way, these are called Classic Pine Stencil, and I'm starting with A, and then I will move on to use B. So A stencil gives you the pine needles, and that's why I'm starting with green. I'm going to cover it up completely with my blending tool. For that I'm using Crisp Ink by Altenew. The color is Evergreen. I'm working on Desert Storm Nina cardstock, and that's a lovely craft color. I have secured that at the back of my stencil with some washi tape. Now I'm going to remove the stencil so you can see the reveal. You can play with a couple of colors of green if you wish to create some variation. I decided to keep it really simple today. And now I'm going to do some inking before I go ahead and use the next stencil. So I will ink up the edges. For that I'm using again Altenew Crisp Ink, and that's Espresso. You can use any inks that you have on hand, and you can see that these inks by Altenew blend really beautifully. I'm not pressing my blending tool at all, I'm going really smoothly over the cardstock, so that I can get a lovely and even blending. Now, there is a reason why I didn't use my Distress inks, and I'm going to explain it later on. For now I'm going to place the stencil on top. It's really easy to align it, just make sure that you don't see any of the green pine needles at all. And then all I did was to just cover up completely with Espresso ink again. And now you can see how easy it is to clean up this ink. Just a little bit of water and you are ready to go. I need to make sure that this stencil is completely clean, since I will be using it one more time over the card. Now you can call this done, turn it into a card by just sticking a sentiment. However, I'm going to show you a few more steps on what you can do on top of it. So here I'm just adding some gesso. This is gesso diluted with water, and I'm adding lots of splashes. This is going to give the a look and feel of snow. And I'm going to show you a great technique which I'm sure you will all love. I'm going to place the stencil again on top, try to align it correctly. I'm going to secure it in place with some washi tape at the back, and then I'm going to apply some embossing paste. This is embossing paste by Altenew, but it doesn't matter, you can use any modeling paste that you might have at home, or even you can work with gesso. So I will be using this spatula. This is a silicone spatula which I find works really great for this technique, just because it is quite elastic. Notice how little of paste I pick up every time with my spatula, and then I'm going to spread it out over the pine cones, making sure that I don't cover up everything completely. This is going to give the look and feel of snow over the pine cones when I will remove the stencil. Also make sure that the ink that you used underneath is completely dry, otherwise it might react with the embossing paste you put over it. And that's the reason why I didn't use my Distress Oxide inks underneath for the background. They react like crazy with mediums on top, and I didn't want my white snow to turn into brown by picking color from underneath. So I'm going to peel off the stencil, and you can see the lovely result with all that snow on top of my pine cones. I absolutely love it. Now I created a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5 out of a chocolate brown cardstock, and I'm going to stick my panel on top of it, making sure that I have a little brown border all around. Now I'm going to finish off my card by adding the sentiment. For that I white embossed it on that brown chocolate cardstock, and I have also cut out a little thin strip of that craft cardstock so that I can stick one on top of the other to create a little frame for that. I also used foam squares at the back of the sentiment to add some dimension, and I'm going to stick that at the center of my card. And here is the finished look. I absolutely love the stencils. I think they are perfect for the season, and they are really unique. Here are some close-up photos on the project that I made for today. You will find linked down below everything I used. I hope you had fun today, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.